night at 10, 1 month after a water main break on Madison's east side, people in the Rodney Scheel House still aren't home. Amy Reed toured the damage and joins us now to show us what they still need. Amy?
Yeah, for those that aren't familiar, the Rodney Scheel House is a nonprofit that helps people with HIV or AIDS by giving them a place to call home. But after a water main break flooded the nonprofit's main floor last month, seven of the people who usually live there are still waiting to come home.
It looks rather devastating. I mean, it's just stripped down to the bare bones here, and usually it's, you know, it's somewhat lively, it's decorated, it's a welcoming environment, and now it just looks trashed.
Jennifer Campbell takes me through the construction zone.
We generally have a very nice common area.
1 month after a water main break on Oak Street, this is as far as they could get. The people who live here now staying in hotels.
And I wasn't expecting how long it would take. So I was hoping, you know, within a couple weeks, residents would be back, we'd be able to be up and running, but I think we're going on week six. Something like that, and we still have a couple weeks to go.
While the people are out, their stuff sits in storage containers outside, locked and secure, but not where it belongs.
This property has become a home to these residents. A lot of them come out of homelessness. A lot of them don't have any other place to live. So then when they come into this community, we want them to feel safe and secure, and something like this happens, it kind of throws a wrench in our plans.
Insurance is covering most of the repairs to the property, but not the thousands it costs to give residents another home. $15,000.
We're looking at another $3,000 to $5,000 if we stay on track with the timeline.
And climbing.
It's a lot of money.
It's money they're willing to spend. Giving these people a home is what they do, but it's money that could have gone somewhere else. And that may be the hardest part. The Rodney Scheel House needs all the help they can get. So they have a GoFundMe set up. The link to that will be available on our website.
Amy Reed reporting. Amy, thank you.